this week's chapter of My Hero Academia was very, very amazing. And honestly, I think this is one of the best chapters in recent months, which is kind of really hard to top since My Hero's been basically on a roll this entire year. But these this chapter right here was very, very good. We finally got the quirk reveal for Star and Stripe, and her quirk is so blatantly overpowered, and they really try to get that point across during this chapter. They really try and get the reader to realize that this quirk is kind of one of the strongest, like the pinnacle in terms of quirks, and so much so that even this All For One Shigaraki fusion, kind of, which we're also going to get into in this chapter, even they're kind of like, we need this quirk. Like, if we get this, we're basically unstoppable, which honestly, at this point, with what it's looking like, that might actually happen. And if they do get this quirk, they probably will become nigh unstoppable. But let's just jump right into the chapter. The chapter starts off with a very, very cool cover page. Not really a cover page, I think this is like the Jump, the cover page for Jump, not really a color page or a cover page for the actual chapter, but it looks very cool. It's basically just Shigaraki and Deku both reaching out and, you know, basically just grabbing for something, and it's very cool. I really do like this page, and you know, it looks really nice. We start off exactly where we left off last week, though, with Star and Stripe standing atop the jets, and right now they're basically saying that, you know, they realize that Shigaraki can also use EMP Blast, and they're telling all their units, or what I'm assuming is like the main commander of like the flight of all the jets, he's telling everybody to disengage autopilot and turn their force fields on to, you know, try and protect themselves from any EMP blasts so they don't just start falling out of the sky. They then ask Star and Stripe, you know, what does she want to do? Does she want to engage or retreat? And she blatantly says that the only option left is to smash. So she's saying that the only thing they have left to do is destroy Shigaraki. The flight commander, I'm assuming, says that, copy that. And he's saying, let's just hope that at least one of our jets makes it back to base, which what I would assume would be like the jet that maybe she's standing on. And she's telling them to take formation and that they're about to exterminate a villain. They're also saying that if you were to fall in this battle right now, we'll make sure that we bring your bodies back to the US or back to your home. So basically just showing that everybody there kind of knows that they're very likely to die in this battle, but you know, it's all for the greater good and they do understand that. We then cut back to Shigaraki, and he's basically saying that he knows that he's Shigaraki, or I think it's like from All For One's perspective, he's saying that he knows he is Shigaraki, but at the same time, he isn't really Shigaraki, or basically there's some weird stuff going on with how they kind of merge bodies, and I'm assuming what's happening right now is that their souls are literally merging together, which becomes prevalent, or something similar is happening near the end of this chapter that we're going to get into, but there's definitely some weird stuff going on with the fact that Shigaraki seemingly getting the one for all quirk, or all for one quirk, seemingly kind of caused both of them to really fuse spiritually, I'm guessing. So it's kind of like, it's not really two people, it's like one new person. He then charges up this huge radio wave blast that is, it's insane in size, it dwarfs all of the actual jets, and it's just very big, and it looks like a lot of the jets were actually able to move out of the way and, you know, move into safety, but it's just crazy the scale of this fight already going into the chapter. It's huge. Shigaraki then starts doing some smack talking. He's basically saying who's going to get the first touch in, you know, who's going to be able to defeat each other, since seemingly in this fight, whoever hits first kind of wins. At least that's what he's seeing at the moment, but he's basically just taunting her, saying who's going to do it first, who's going to get the first touch in, all of that. Star and Stripe then remarks back that even if she did know about all his hidden other quirks and, you know, all the tricks that he has up his sleeve, she says that she wouldn't even need to prepare for them, and she says that's what it means to be the strongest, basically talking down to Shigaraki right now. This is where the chapter gets pretty insane, and I didn't realize what was going on in the first couple of panels that I saw, but then you start to realize that she's grabbing onto the atmosphere itself. And I didn't really understand that at first. I was like, atmosphere, what does that mean? And then it says Star and Stripe's quirk, and she says the atmosphere from here to 100%, 100 meters in front of me will cease to exist. And I'm guessing her quirk is called New Order. And this quirk is so blatantly overpowered that it's very insane, and they really try to get the point across during this chapter. So she's literally able to touch anything, and it seemingly is anything, since she was able to touch something that isn't really even physical, which is the atmosphere, and she basically made it cease to exist. And she can do really whatever she wants with this quirk, not just make stuff cease to exist. She can just play around with whatever she wants to and do whatever she really wants with that thing that she touched, which is very insane. So if she wanted to, I'm guessing she could just, if she wanted to, she probably could have touched Shigaraki and made it to like, oh, you can't move anymore. Or, you know, she could touch the air and like, the air is toxic. Or maybe she could really potentially do anything. I don't think there really is an upper limit to this quirk, and I think that's why it's so blatantly powerful and scary and really shows off just how much of a monster she is. Getting back into the chapter though, after being hit by the quirk, Shigaraki says, "What a horrifying quirk," and he's definitely realizing just how crazy she is. And basically after this, they're saying that, you know, that probably isn't going to be enough to really put you down. So all of the jets shoot out huge laser beams, all directed at Shigaraki's core, and they all are direct hits. But Shigaraki then uses another quirk of his reflection and refraction and shoots back the lasers. But this doesn't do anything to Star and Stripes, and she's able to control lasers also, which is, you know, if she wasn't already OP, this is pretty insane. She then realizes that he's starting to regenerate from the damage that he got from the lasers, and she realizes that, or she says that this is, you know, why the Japanese weren't really able to take down Shigaraki, because his regeneration was just too much for them to really handle. Shigaraki then notices that after she reflected the lasers, or she absorbed it and it didn't do anything, he realizes that her quirk basically came undone, and he is able to move through the atmosphere essentially. And he's wondering, is this the upper limit of the quirk? Is, you know, is this the limit of it? Like, what's going on right now? And he uses this chance to use his arm boosters to basically like slingshot or boost forward to Star and Stripe. But this is basically exactly what Star and Stripe wanted, and she also remarks that, you know, this is exactly what I wanted to happen. And she instantly knocks Shigaraki back. Like, it didn't even matter that he was moving at her at such a speed, she was able to counter it and just knock him flat. This is when we learn about the limits to the quirk, seemingly. You know, even though it's still a very blatantly powerful quirk, there is the limit that she can only really have two different rules over two different things at one moment. So they also remark that she usually has one of these rules used on herself to give her the super strength, and then, you know, she'll use another rule accordingly during the fight. So right now she's only really able to have one rule over Shigaraki at a time, which is still very powerful, but this is seemingly the limit to the quirk. We also get a bit into her backstory, and we learn that a long time ago there was a Japanese exchange student that was in America, and we know that this was All Might. And she's basically saying that a runaway villain attacked them in their car, and she was basically okay with dying, she said, as long as her little sister was able to escape. And it seems that All Might was able to save both her and her little sister, and she says that the memory of his two strands of hair were basically engraved into her mind, and, you know, this is what she always remembered, and this is where her idolization of All Might started, after he was able to save them from this perilous situation where she thought that she was going to most definitely die. She idolized him so much so that instead of just doing the two strands of hair, the really long one, she went with eight to really just pay homage to All Might and try and emulate him as much as she could, since she basically revered him. She then starts talking to Shigaraki, and she says that, oh, by the way, I actually did touch you and I said your name, which we do see in the panels beforehand. And I also think it's really cool that we do realize whenever she is using her quirk, since the actual panels in the chapter have like the stripes on them, the stripes from the US flag, and that's very cool to me. Like, it's really small, but that's just cool to me, so we know exactly when she is using her quirk. She then gives an insane order, and she says that if Shigaraki Tomura were to move an inch from this spot right onwards, his heart will stop, which is basically just an insta-kill ability. That's very insane. She can instantly win a fight just by touching you, and you really can't do anything about it. We then get these two insane panels where it's like we kind of just see the ambition and everything kind of just escape Shigaraki's eyes, and he says, I'm caught, and he starts to think like, man, like, that was it, like, I'm really done for in this situation. This is also where we get some interesting revelations in the chapter, and we get a panel where it's basically in that mind space with Tomura, Shigaraki, and One for All, or All for One. And he's basically saying that, you know, if it was him, it would have taken him about 2 months to recover from everything. But he's saying that Shigaraki was able to recover way quicker than even he was. And he's saying that Shigaraki's incredible. And he's also saying that his hate, everything, his desire is just so much. And he's saying that at right about now, if he could quantify their power, I'm assuming, he's saying that they'd be around 97 or 98%. And he's saying that, you know, although this is the case, we're neither Tomura Shigaraki nor All For One. And he's saying that a new being is about to emerge. And we see that this is kind of the reason why her quirk seemingly isn't going to work on him, since this is like a new person being born into the world. Since I'm assuming it's like a spiritual mix of both All For One and Shigaraki, which All For One is seemingly, he's out there in the world, but his spirit that was inside of the All For One quirk is seemingly merging with Shigaraki's spirit, and it's creating like a whole new person. So it's neither Shigaraki, it's neither All For One, it's going to be somebody new. And since it's somebody new and isn't necessarily Shigaraki himself, her quirk isn't going to work on him right now. In this situation, he's probably going to use that as the opportunity to basically end her, which I hope doesn't happen. But once I get into the last two panels, or the last final panels of the chapter, it's probably going to be the case. The final panels of the chapter are basically Shigaraki, or this new being, basically saying no. And Star and Stripe is starting to think, why isn't my quirk working? Is he not Tomura Shigaraki? And Shigaraki starts saying to hate me, nature me, or nurture me more, hate me even more. And he's saying that our hatred will give birth to our glorious future. And we see him seemingly stand up and move forward, which is showing that the quirk wasn't able to work on him, since he's able to move forwards. And he's saying that it all began at that home, and slowly his hatred accumulated, basically from the start, from when he was in that household with his parents. His hatred was accumulating, and this is basically the breaking point of that. And the chapter ends with the final panel being them up in the sky, and there's a bright light and like seeming like black whip looking lightning basically flying all around them, and the chapter ends, and we have a break next week. So but this is a very good chapter though, and I don't know what's going to happen next week. Seemingly we're going to get a whole new person that isn't really Shigaraki, but isn't really All For One either, and it's going to be very insane. I'm going to be kind of sad if this, if Star and Stripe kind of loses already, since we haven't really even gotten too much of her, and we're just now learning what her quirk is and how she fights during this chapter. So it'd be very unfortunate if she were to basically die the next chapter when we get it in 2 weeks. But you know, I'm thinking that probably is going to be what happens, since if she is around in the story, then there kind of is no hope for Shigaraki or this new being or whatever if she's around. So they're probably going to have to get rid of her in the story, which I understand, but it's still kind of unfortunate. I wish we would have gotten more with her, but it does seem like this is going to be her end next week. But this is also going to spell the beginnings of a very horrible future for the hero, seemingly, since if Shigaraki or this new being or whatever is able to get her quirk, they really are going to become almost unstoppable. And I'm not even sure how Deku is going to really stand a chance against that, or all the heroes in general, because that's just blatantly overpowered. Like, Shigaraki was already very powerful beforehand, even in his incomplete form. In his complete form, he'd be very powerful already, and now he has this blatantly borderline broken quirk that's bordering on being impossible to really deal with. We also can't be 100% sure how the chapter is going to go in 2 weeks, but I definitely do think this is going to spell the end for Star and Stripe. But all in all, this was still an amazing chapter. I very much enjoyed it, and this is honestly peak My Hero. Like, I don't know, like, just this past year, the past year plus really has been Horikoshi's just best work. I feel like I really do feel like My Hero is in one of its best spots right now, and this chapter right now was honestly amazing, and I really am excited to see the next one. But let me know what you guys thought of the chapter. Like the video if you liked it, and please subscribe. You know, it really does help out, and I really do appreciate everybody that supports the channel and watches the videos. And I'm hoping, you know, one day soon I can really be able to double down and make more videos, and probably make this like a daily thing, or you know, as a future career. But I definitely do appreciate anybody that does watch this video, and just let me know what you guys thought of the chapter and what you guys think will happen next week. I'll probably put out a sort of prediction video and see what different things could occur for next week, but you know, that might happen later on this week. But thank you for watching, and I'm out.